He knows his way around. He doesn't need me. There you go. Right in here? Okay, you got it? Oops, sorry. Slam the door in your face. Yeah. All right, Axel's in there.
Axel Rose is doing our thing.
Let me ask you this. Okay. You know how there's a lot of
you thought it was about what the hell? There's only supposed to be two guys in the band.
Hey, we bring a posse, man. We have a posse, man. All right.
Out, spider webs. I just I just don't get it. I'm feeling copacetic. Hey, it's the guys from Local H are here.
Hello.
Welcome to town, guys.
Thank you.
We have Scott Lucas and we have Joe Daniels.
That's us.
What's up? Are you guys... Oh, not much. I just heard you saying, like you were trying to wake up or something. Are these early hours, these normal hours for you?
This is pretty early for me, man.
I imagine. Can you just grab that microphone and pull a little closer because I'm having a hard time picking you up. Cool. So the show is tonight with Orange 9mm and a band called Shift.
No. No, Shift's not on it, and I don't know who's... opening up, but there's somebody else.
Well, that's what we had here, and I just like saying shift and putting a low accent on the F, so people
shift?
Think I'm swearing. Yeah.
Shift.
So to say the actual swear word, which would be...
No, don't be getting me in trouble here.
Well, shift.
Tonight it's at the Masquerade, and this is not your first time through town, even on this current tour, is it?
On this tour it is, but we've been here like probably five or six, something like that. Chris would know.
This would be the...
Chris is videotaping everything. It's a documentary.
Yes, and you're in it.
It's a mockumentary.
Not my middle finger's in it.
It is.
So the band Local H, this is the trippiest thing. When people hear this song, actually the biggest compliment I think anybody could have ever given you is I played the song the other night and somebody probably caught it after I introduced it and heard the middle of it to the end and waited and called me two songs later and they said, hey, what was that Nirvana song you played two songs ago?
Oh, yeah?
So you don't think that's pretty complimentary?
You think Bound for the Floor sounds like Nirvana?
No.
All right, that was the proper answer.
Maybe he really likes Nirvana. Maybe he thought, wow, I really like this Local H band. And by the way, what does copacetic mean? It's not in the dictionary, you know. It's slang.
It is in the dictionary.
No, it's not.
Are you serious?
Webster's Dictionary.
It's not an actual dictionary word.
Because I was going to give the full meaning out one night when we first started playing the song, and everybody's like, hey, what does copacetic mean? And it's kind of like an old beach term, like, hey, everything's cool, capiche.
Oh, so it's a 60s hippie type thing.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Well, then how did you write it? I mean, what were you thinking when you wrote it?
I'd heard it used before.
Oh, okay. But the meaning being okay, cool,
right,
fine.
Basically, right. Keep everything calm.
Okay, and the other big question about Local H is two guys, like I said, Scott and Joe. And Joe, you're on drums. Scott, how you playing the bass and the guitar at the same time?
I got a bass pickup in the guitar, and it feeds into a bass amp, and it takes care of the bottom end and everything like that.
Did you experimenting on your own? Did you come up with this?
We took the guitar to a friend of ours, and we had him put the pickup in there for us. And that was the first thing we tried, and that's what we stuck with.
Right, because originally, this is the second CD, As Good As Dead, but the original band lineup, there were four guys, and two of the guys bailed, and you just said, hey.
Well, our first record has two people on it as well.
Okay.
So, I mean, you know, when we were like four people, that was a while ago, so.
And the two guys, the bass player and the guitar player,
Cliff? Yeah, there's another guitar player.
Another guitar player?
Basically. Yeah.
They became janitors.
They became janitors. And now you guys are touring the Wild West, or we're in the South.
East, wherever we're at.
East right now, right. Just a quick, then, or a question as far as all your guitars go, then. Do you, how many guitars you use on stage? You change a lot? Or, I mean, all the guitars have to be this way. And a lot of times guitars have like three or four pickups on them. So.
It doesn't really change the way the guitars are set up. It's just an extra pickup in it for the bass. And that's all. So it's just a normal guitar with a bass pickup in it.
Well, you guys have the instruments, so you want to play something right now.
Are you going to be able to hear?
Yeah, we'll be able to hear. I mean, give us a drum check right now. Let me hear if I can hear those drums.
La, 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 la. Can you hear all that?
I can hear all that.
Can you hear it?
See, you got sound check on the radio,
la, la,
huh?
La, la, la. Can you hear it?
Yes, I can.
All right, here we go. Want to hear something?
I want to hear something.
All right, here we go.
Yeah.
99X live in the studios.
Thank you.
Local H.
Thank you for all the applause.
Two people making that much noise, and there's like eight of us, and we make the applause of one person.
Well,
things are inverted. Things are reverted a little bit. How odd is it that that it is two of you guys in the band? I mean, are you gonna expand beyond this? I mean, are you gonna put bagpipes underneath your arms and like the cymbals in between your knees?
That's a good idea, actually. That's interesting to me, rather than getting a bass player. That would be cool.
Never, but this is the band. This is how it's going to be.
This is it.
And then when you guys jump on stage tonight at the Masquerade, there's not going to be any other musicians. I mean, it's just you.
Just a little kazoo player.
A little kazoo player. And orange 9mm as well. So what are the advantages of being... Do you even think about this, or is this... I mean, this is just such a shocking
more
thing
money.
To... More money.
More beer.
More beer on the tour bus.
More chicks.
More chicks. There we go.
More guys.
For Scott.
And we have to send a special message.
Gavin, this one's for you.
Hey, what's the deal between you guys and Gavin? We were talking about this. I was playing Spiderwebs when you guys walked in, and I said, wow, did you hear about that?
A fine song.
No doubt, Spiderwebs.
That is a great song.
And I said, wow, isn't that pretty wild? Like Gwen Stefani dating Gavin?
We don't talk about Nirvana. Let's talk Bush. Anyway, let's...
Now you're bitter about the Nirvana compliment. I thought the guy just thought, hey, maybe that's like a weird B-side that I never heard, and he just heard the guitars a little bit. I mean, you guys are obviously not a rip-off of Nirvana.
We love Nirvana. We think Nirvana's great.
Yeah.
There you go.
I can't wait for the new record.
There's not going to be a new record.
Oh,
Scott.
That's what you say,
hey,
man.
Hey, there's a new record out,
that's
man.
What you say.
Yeah, that's
I'm
true.
I'm going to keep believing.
That's true. They're going to keep putting out more and more stuff with that name on it. So what do you guys want to talk about? I mean, you guys are from Zion,
let's
Illinois.
Talk about you, man. You're from Naperville.
I'm from Naperville, Illinois, right.
So
something your listeners may not know is that everybody from the West Coast and from the South is actually from Illinois.
It's crazy.
Everything's out of Chicago.
Everyone's from Illinois. What's up there?
I don't know, but Zion, Illinois, what were you saying? That's near Waukegan, so that's a little bit northwest.
Mm-hmm. It's right on the border of Illinois and Wisconsin.
Because with the Braves game tonight, I was thinking, you know, I wasn't sure if it was one of the southeastern cities or southwestern cities actually in Illinois, and you might be a St. Louis Cardinals fan. I didn't know what you felt about baseball. What are your feelings about the baseball the series going on right now?
Scott's really.
Let me tell you my feelings.
That.
Here we go. Ready?
Mm-hmm. There are none.
I have no feelings about baseball.
It could affect you a little bit, you think?
Oh, why? Because
tonight?
Yeah, who's, because who's music that fans chump? May not want to come to see a rock show. They might rather go see a
or sit at home and watch.
A,
it no,
baseball?
It's baseball. Oh, we're in baseball season
basketball
right now.
That's true. That might happen. And if that's going to happen, you know, that's what VCRs are invented for. Tape the damn game. Come out to see some rock.
That's right. Live rock and roll tonight at the Masquerade. Orange 9mm, Local H. No shift? No?
No shift.
No shift. Well, hang on a second. I've got to go to the bathroom really quick, and then you guys have instruments, and I want to ask you a couple more questions. No shift.
No shift, man.
With Local H, and this is their second CD, As Good As Dead.
Yeah.
And you guys have been traveling around. This was released back in April, I believe. So you guys have been traveling around, seen a lot of things, met a lot of interesting people. What's the wildest thing that's happened to you so far?
We've seen the wildest thing. The
let's see. I guess I should say Marilyn Manson was at our show in Milwaukee. That's probably the wildest.
That was kind of wild, playing Bound for the Floor and looking out and seeing some dude with two different colored eyes looking at you. That was pretty weird.
He was in character, even going out and checking out other music?
Yeah, you know what was even weirder was talking to him and having this weirdo.
Finding out that he isn't weird.
Yeah, just having, I don't know what was weirder was, you know, it's just like he acted like a normal person, which was weird to me.
Mm-hmm. So we
you know
see
what I mean?
It's a money-making scam.
It is a scam.
I knew somebody that used to work there.
I don't believe he actually believes in Satan. I don't think he does.
I love that line. Remember the Beatles proclaimed they were bigger than Jesus, and Marilyn Manson now has proclaimed that they're bigger than Satan.
Oh. Well, that's, you know, that's great.
Prophetic for Mr. Marilyn.
That's terrific.
You guys have the instruments, so you're welcome to play another song. I would love for you guys to play another song.
We could play this song called Eddie Vedder. But can I say the... Oh, we've already gone through this. I can't say the S word, can I?
You can say shift.
I'll say shift.
As in the band that was supposed to be playing tonight at the Masquerade.
This goes out to shift, since they're not going to be here.
All right, Local H on 99X.
As good as dead.
dead. Ow! Local H, live in the 99X studios. As good
Thank
as
you.
Dead.
We appreciate your applause. It warms our cockles.
Your cockles will be warm tonight at the Masquerade. I doubt there any fan of, like, a true fan of really good music, Local H, Orange 9mm, you know, a baseball game's not going to get in the way. It's going to be a great time out there tonight. I'm sure there's still a couple of tickets left at the door. The Masquerade box office, that's where you get them.
We'll sell hot dogs.
You'll sell hot dogs.
We'll sell hot dogs, and there'll be lots of beer. So, you know, I mean, it'll feel like we're there.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, what Scott said. That's what I like about you guys. No BS, just straight ahead. Nothing. It's all stripped down and straight ahead rock and
That's
roll.
That's right. And we'll even bring the twisty fries.
We're Illinois boys, man.
I love twisty fries.
Do you guys like bratwurst?
Bratwurst?
That would be, no.
Oh, okay.
I like a good poli sausage.
We might get you a poli sausage tonight at the Masquerade.
I hope so. But you know what? You probably don't know how to make poli sausage out here.
I've never seen one down here.
You don't know what you're missing, man.
I think we better go before we break something, but I really appreciate you, Scott and Joe, you guys for stopping by. Local H, the second CD
Thanks.
Is as good as dead.
The cops are here.
Those were two really cool songs. Yeah, there's this big red light going off because one of the hotlines is ringing.
You did say
shift, didn't you, with an F?
I totally said shift.
Okay. Local H, they're at the Masquerade tonight. Hey, I don't have to play a commercial. I can play another song. Soundgarden. What do you guys think about Soundgarden?
Soundgarden
won't even get
rules.
Into it. Okay. Blow up the outside world at Soundgarden. Thank you very much, Local H, for stopping by.
Thanks for having us, man.
You're listening to 99X.